What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today I'm gonna be doing a review on the Fluger Supreme size 30 and the size 35 spinning reels. So I have had the size 35 reel for almost 2 years now, and honestly this is by far my favorite spinning reel. So it fits great in my hand. I actually have it on about a 7 foot medium action spinning rod, and right now I have 8 pound test braid on it. But one of the things I love the most about this reel is the drag system. Super smooth. So I catch a lot of smallmouth on this rod and reel, and when you hook a big smallmouth, you gotta let them run, right? So I'll pull on this line for you here and let you hear the drag. Super smooth. So when you get those fish hooked, loosen up the drag, let them run, and the reel will handle it for you.
That's a big one. Holy crap. Oh my gosh, that's another giant.
As you can see here, I have almost a 5 pound smallmouth hooked, and I'm just gonna fight it out on this reel. Let him run, give him drag, and just let him do what he wants.
Yeah, that's another huge one. Holy crap. Yeah, sure. Giant smallie. Jeez. That's another 5 or close.
Okay, hope you enjoyed that clip of a mega smallmouth that I caught using this reel. But now we're gonna get into talking about the size 30. So I just ordered this. I ordered a brand new rod and reel combo. I'm planning on throwing this reel with much lighter line on my hair jig rod, or like a drop shot. Super finessey setup. The size 30 is a little bit smaller, as you can see here. You can tell the difference. A little bit smaller than the size 35. Again, super smooth drag system. I'll read some of the information off the box. The max drag on the size 30 reel is 10 pounds. The weight of the reel is 7.5 ounces, which is pretty light. The gear ratio is 6.2 to 1, which is 31.8 inches per turn. The braid capacity is 190 yards of 8 pound and 160 yards of 10 pound. So what I usually do is I usually put some backing line of like some old fluorocarbon or some line that is old or that I've finished using or that I'm not gonna use, that I just have laying around. Put it on here, and then I either tie a uni knot or use a piece of electrical tape to tie that down, and then put my braid over the top so I don't waste an entire spool of braid all the way down to the bottom of the spool. If you're like me, you don't like to spend a ton of money on rods and reels because your budget is not unlimited. So this reel, the size 30, was right at about $85 I got off of Amazon. I will link both of the links to these reels in the description. Really appreciate it if you're gonna buy one. Use that link. I get a little bit of percentage of that purchase if you do use those links through Amazon. So go check those out. I definitely recommend these two reels. Like I said, these are by far my favorite reels. I haven't used this one yet, but I know just from this one that it's gonna be a good one. This reel has caught me a ton of fish, super smooth, and by far my favorite spinning reel. Alright guys, I know this video was short and sweet. I hope it helped you out. I hope I got you some information to help you make the decision whether or not to buy this reel or not. Like I said, I would definitely recommend either the size 30 or the size 35 for finesse fishing. The size 35 is a little bigger, can hold a little bit more line, so that might be helpful in whatever situation you're using it for. But if you enjoyed this video, I'd really appreciate it if you give it a like. Hit that subscribe button for me. I'm gonna start doing some more product reviews on my channel. Super excited to get this thing set up on my hair jig slash drop shot rod. Look forward to using it on my videos in the future. Hopefully get some good content for you guys. Appreciate you watching. Good luck on the water. Take care, guys.
That one?
Yep.
Come on. Head chugger. Oh. Oh, dude. Dude. Oh my god. This is a huge one. You got the net? Oh. Oh my goodness. Holy crap. That is a tank. Look at that fish.
Huh? That's a 20.
Got it absolutely choked, too.
Another beauty.